Karim Nassar from Siemens Digital Industries Software. Today, I'm going to show you how to quickly set up simulation runs with Simcenter System Analyst. The goal is to evaluate hundreds of system variations and select appropriate parameters and components without having to manipulate complex models. Let's start by selecting system variants from an available architecture. The available architectures are those created and deployed in the database by model architects. The choice of the system variant can be done based on the physical architecture, for instance, conventional P2 hybrid or pure electric vehicles and so on. And otherwise, the choice can be made based on the attributes the architecture was designed to solve, such as drivability, fuel economy, etc. The next step is to select appropriate components that are part of the architecture to configure your technical definition. Choosing a component from the database means both selecting a model and a set of parameters that refers to a reference of components. It can be a gearbox, for instance, reference 1, which is of type CVT, relying on a CVT model, or a gearbox, let's say reference 2, of type DCT, relying on a DCT gearbox. Selection of the appropriate model is made automatically behind the scenes. You can refine a component or create a new component by changing its parameters. By double-clicking on a component from an architecture, you can access all the parameters that are left by the model architect as degrees of freedom. You can change individual scalar values or even change values within a map. When achieved, this new parameter set can be published in the database and shared with other analysts. Select parameter variations, in this case it can be scenarios, and then select normalized cycles and performance cycles. Once you have selected all the parameters and settings, you can run the simulations. The models will then be created, configured, and parameterized automatically on the platform that was chosen by the model architect, for instance, Simcenter AIMSIM or Simulink. And then they will be simulated. You can then browse the results of the simulations and monitor the temporal trace of the variables that were chosen and instrumented by the model architects. You can also monitor analysis criteria that have been created by the model architects, such as fuel consumption, maximum speed, time to reach a given distance, and so on. These scalars can also be monitored on dedicated plots, such as spider charts, bar charts, and so on, to compare the respective merit of various technical definitions with multiple attributes. Finally, you can trigger dedicated post-processing actions that were created and attached by the model architect. Those can be based on Python or MATLAB scripts to visualize specific plots, results, or export values into third-party software like Excel or MATLAB. To sum up, we have shown how you can easily set up and run multi-attribute analyses without prior knowledge thanks to the Simcenter System Analyst platform. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.